I started as an artist. I went to film school, so I would consider, I wanted to become a director. But eventually, life takes its course, and I ended up working in an advertising company as a copywriter. Eventually, I became a creative director, and I realized I had a whole of holes in the creative department and teaching other people how to create. And so I closed the creative department on Fridays, and I started bringing people in that would teach us strategies and ways to solve creative problems. And one of the teachers was an art teacher. Eventually, he came to my house, we started painting, he started teaching me how to paint, and I fell in love with painting. 2 years later, I left the advertising world and I embarked on a journey. I went to Cuba and studied there as an Alejandro. Eventually, I went to the New York Studio School, and I went back to Venezuela. That's how I started, in a nutshell. I did this in early 2020, February, right before the pandemic. It was the last work I actually did, because from there I couldn't go to my studios, the one in Miami and the one in Mexico. It was just probably the last large work I did this year. This work in particular has to do, and we have to go back to Cuba and how Cuba affected me. Because in the year I was there, it was 1997 to 1999, Chavez came into power. And I had naive ideas about politics, but being in Cuba and seeing Venezuela change so drastically, so soon, affected me in ways that I tried to avoid, and I tried not to think about politics and for many years. But eventually, the collapse in my country was such that it forced me to take these issues and think about them and think, what was it in my view that changed that affected Venezuela so much? And my conclusion was that crude oil created an environment, a unique environment in Venezuela that distorted everything, distorted how we relate to each other, that distorted the economy, because pretty much everything was subsidized by 30,000 people that managed the economy of oil, the extraction and export of oil. So I was thinking that, and funny enough, in Cuba, one of the materials, we didn't find materials to work, many materials, so one of the materials we worked with was betún de Judea, which is pretty much bitumen, thinned down with mineral spirits. And that was my first approximation to the material of crude oil. Eventually, I went back to Venezuela, as I said, and I started making pieces that had to do with crude oil and how crude oil had distorted our relationships with everything. Eventually, I came and I did some mirrors, acrylic boxes that were filled with bitumen that I heat up to 500 degrees Fahrenheit, and they distort the acrylic. So when you flip it over and you see the acrylic side, you have perfect black mirrors, but you see this yourself distorted, somewhat like if you were walking into a fun house. Eventually, I thought, many of these resins that I work with and plastics that I use, obviously, are derivatives of crude oil, and I substitute the crude oil with this resins. And what I do is I pour, as if it was bitumen heated to 500 degrees. I pour this resins and make these mirrors that somewhat distort the person that is looking at them. And again, I think art is actually something. It's an activity, it's something that happens, from the making of it to the thinking of it to actually the perceiving of it. When you see a work of art that reflects yourself, you see yourself as an object. And then something very mysterious happens, because mirrors have a quality of being, as Umberto Eco calls them, describes them, the threshold between the real and the symbolic. There's a membrane there that you cross when you see the mirror. You see yourself as an object. And in here, you see yourself reflected by the distortion of crude oil, which is not only, I use Venezuela as a case, but it's really a sample of a larger universe. Venezuela is just a sample of this addiction that we have to crude oil as a society, and that we need to overcome, and that we need to leave behind as soon as possible, because it's ruining our planet, it's ruining our ecosystem, and eventually it will destroy us as well.